little bit into the yarn. Once I spin it once, it actually doesn't work too well. So I spin two or more together, you can get it. And a spin wheel works like a bicycle. I like to describe it. So you pedal it with your foot. It turns this. This is like your chain. So this is not what I'm actually spinning. And it moves this part here, which is actually composed of two pieces. Let me show you on the side. So this is what it's actually doing. It winds it on for me. And this part puts the twist in it. So they move at different speeds. Actually two pieces. Now this is nice because it can get a lot done. But I'm stuck in one spot. So a lot of times I'll use these. These are drop spindles. They work just like your spinning wheel does. But I can get up and move around with them. But they're a lot slower. Just like my spinning wheel, what I'm doing is I'm pulling it and I'm letting that twist travel up. And I have to stop and wind it on. But from here, if I wanted to make clothes out of it, I could either knit it, crochet it, or I could weave it. Now, last time I spun yarn to weave a blanket, it took me 6 days to spin the yarn, and it took me a whole day to weave it. So it takes 6 days to make enough yarn to spin to weave for one day. You spin yarn for six, weave one day. It doesn't leave a lot of time for hardly anything else.